Hello, everybody. I'm Parsha Becky, and we are back for another week of Parsha. As I'm sure you recall, we are now in the middle of reading the second book of Chumash, the book of Shmot. Shmot means names, and the name of this week's Parsha is Vaera, which means I appeared. Now, it's called that this Parsha is picking up right where last week's Parsha left off. If you remember, last week's Parsha ended right in the middle of a conversation. Moshe, I complained to Hashem. He said, Hashem, you know, as soon as I went to talk to Pharaoh, things got worse. I don't want to make things worse. And Hashem said, no, Moshe, it looks bad now, but things are going to get better. You'll see it's all part of the plan. And now this week's Parsha is continuing that conversation. Hashem keeps speaking. Hashem says, Va'era, I appeared to Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov, which we read all about in earlier Parshas in the book of Bereishit. Hashem says, and I promised them the land of Israel for them and for their children forever. And I'm going to keep my promise, Moshe. Don't think I'm not. So to keep that promise, don't worry. I've got a whole plan. I'm going to take the Jewish people out of Egypt. I'm going to bring them to Israel, and I'm going to give them the land of Israel to be theirs. The Parsha reminds us that at this point in time, Moshe is 80 years old, and his brother Aaron is 83, which is, you know, a nice young age to start a new career. And it also reminds us about the teamwork arrangement that Moshe and Aaron settled on in last week's Parsha, because Moshe doesn't like to do public speaking. So Hashem will talk to Moshe, and Moshe will repeat everything to Aaron, and Aaron will do all the talking for everyone else. Now Moshe and Aaron go to Pharaoh, and they say, hey, Pharaoh, again, Hashem says that you have to let the Jewish people leave Egypt to pray to Hashem for a bit. And Pharaoh's like, yeah, no, I'm not going to do that. So Aaron throws his stick on the ground, and hiss, it turns into a snake. And Pharaoh's like, that's not special. My magicians can turn sticks into snakes too. Look. And his magicians throw their sticks down, and hiss, they turn into snakes. And Aaron's snake gobbles up their sticks. And Pharaoh's like, whatever. So I'm down a couple sticks. I'm still not letting the Jews go. Moshe's like, okay. Next day, Hashem sends Moshe back to Pharaoh while Pharaoh is taking a bath in the river. And Moshe says, hey, so Pharaoh, so Hashem, the God of the Jewish people, says, you got to let the Jews leave to pray to Hashem for a bit. And Pharaoh's like, yeah, why should I? Or else what? And Moshe's like, I'll tell you or else what. I'll tell you why you shouldn't do that. Because if you don't, you see all this water that you're swimming in? That's going to turn into blood. And not just all the water in the river, all the water everywhere in Egypt, no matter what it's in, no matter where it is, it's all going to turn into blood. And Pharaoh's like, I'm not afraid of that. My magicians can turn into blood, water into blood too. So what? So Aaron holds a stick over the river, and Hashem turns all the water in Egypt into blood. In the river, in the puddles, in the ponds, you turn on your tap, it's blood pouring out. You've got a water bottle? Nope, that's a blood bottle now. It's full of blood. Even if it was sealed, you're like pouring yourself a glass of water to drink. Suddenly, it's a glass of blood. All the water is blood. It's disgusting. Goes on for 7 days, but Pharaoh's not budging. So Hashem sends Moshe back to Pharaoh again. Moshe says, hey, Pharaoh, Hashem says you have to let the Jews leave Egypt to pray to Hashem. Pharaoh's like, yeah, that's not going to happen. Moshe's like, well, if you don't agree, then there's going to be frogs everywhere here. Frogs in your head and frogs in your bed, frogs in your nose and frogs in your toes. You know the story, you know the song, Pharaoh. It's going to be frogs jumping everywhere. And Pharaoh's like, yeah, my magicians can make frogs happen too. Big deal. Moshe's like, okay. So Aaron holds his stick up and Hashem brings the plague of frogs. First a frog climbs out of the river, then another and another. And another, and soon the entire land of Egypt is jumping with frogs. Pharaoh wants to get into bed. He lifts up his blanket and cheats. There's a whole bunch of frogs snuggling under the covers. One, maybe they go for a walk. He puts on his shoes, except he can't get his foot in because there's some slimy, squishy frogs inside his shoe. You know what? Time for a snack. He's going to heat up some food, open up the microwave. Dozens of frogs come jumping out. Maybe he'll sit down and open a drawer in his desk. Oh, no, it's full of frogs now. There's frogs everywhere. Finally, Pharaoh can't take it. He says, Moshe, Aaron, please make the frogs stop and I will let the Jews leave. Moshe's like, okay, when do you want the frogs to stop? I'll ask Hashem whenever you want. And Pharaoh's like, how about tomorrow? Moshe's like, okay, I'm going to pray to Hashem. Tomorrow, your frog problem will be gone. Moshe prays to Hashem. The next day, all the frogs in Egypt drop dead. Now, they don't have a frogs jumping everywhere problem. Now, they have a dead frogs problem. They've got piles and piles and piles heaped up really high of dead frogs everywhere. It stinks so badly. And Pharaoh was like, oh yeah, you know, I said you were going to go. I was going to let you go. Joke's on you. I'm not actually going to let you go. So Hashem tells Moshe and Aaron that Aaron's going to hit the ground with his stick. And he does. And all the dust everywhere in Egypt turns into lice. And all the Egyptians are scratching their heads. The magicians are like, we can't even like try to do anything about this one. We're too busy scratching our heads because of all this itchy lice. And Pharaoh's scratching his head. Pharaoh's like, this is really annoying. It's really itchy, but I'm still not letting you go. So Hashem sends Moshe to warn Pharaoh again. Moshe's like, hey, Pharaoh, let the Jews leave Egypt to pray to Hashem for a bit. And Pharaoh's like, no, I'm not gonna. So Moshe's like, well, if you don't, there's going to be some swarms. Now, this is interesting because the wording in the Torah is unclear whether he means swarms of big wild animals or bugs, big wild animals or bugs. But either way, it's annoying, dangerous, kind of scary. And oh, one more thing, these swarms of either big wild animals or bugs, they're going to bother the Egyptians. They're not going to go to the Jewish parts of town, but the Jewish neighborhoods are going to be totally fine. No swarms, only bothering the Egyptians. And Pharaoh's like, I'm not afraid. You can bring, do your worst. So Hashem brings the swarms of either big wild animals or bugs. And Pharaoh realizes that actually this is a problem. So he calls Moshe and Aaron back. And Pharaoh's like, let's make a compromise. How about you guys, Jewish people, can pray to Hashem right here in Egypt? And Moshe says, I like the idea of compromise, but that's not going to work. Because the way that we pray to Hashem is going to be very upsetting to the Egyptians. So much so that they're going to try to murder us if they see us praying to Hashem our way right here. So we have to leave Egypt out of sight where they won't see us so that we can pray to Hashem without getting killed. And Pharaoh's like, you know what? Fine. You can do that. You can go out of Egypt to pray to Hashem so long as you don't go too far and come right back as soon as you're done praying. Moshe's like, okay, deal. I'll pray to Hashem and make this go away. Moshe prays to Hashem and the swarms of either big wild animals or bugs, they go away. They leave Egypt. And Pharaoh's like, oh yeah, actually, I changed my mind. You can't go. So Moshe goes back to Pharaoh and he says, hey, Pharaoh, Hashem says you have to let the Jewish people leave Egypt. And Pharaoh's like, no, I don't want to. And Moshe says, well, if you don't, then all the animals that belong to Egyptians are going to get really sick, maybe die. Fun fact, Moshe says, animals belong to the Jewish people. They'll be 100% fine and healthy. It's only your people's animals that are going to get sick. And Pharaoh's like, well, I don't like the idea of that, but I'm not letting you go. So Hashem makes all the animals belonging to the Egyptians get very, very sick and die. And Pharaoh checks and all the Jewish people's animals are A-okay. And he's like, well, I'm not letting you go anyway. And Hashem sends Moshe back to Pharaoh. Moshe says, hey, Pharaoh, Hashem says you really, really have to let the Jewish people leave Egypt to pray to Hashem. Pharaoh's like, I am not going to do that. And Moshe says, okay, well, you should know that if you don't, there's going to be a storm, and not just any storm. This is going to be hail like you have never seen before, like Egypt has never seen before. It's going to be so bad. Anyone who's smart should take all their stuff inside because anything outside is going to get wrecked. Pharaoh doesn't listen. Some Egyptians do who are scared of Hashem. They take all their stuff inside. Smart of them, because Moshe holds his arm up and Hashem brings a storm. And there's thunder and lightning and heavy rain and there's hail, but not like little hail. So it's like huge, big rocks of ice for hail falling from the sky. And there is fire falling from the sky. There's fire falling from the sky. And it smashes down the trees and all the food that had just grown for the Egyptians to eat is completely destroyed. Everything that's outside is ruined and wrecked. And Pharaoh is terrified. And he calls Moshe and Aaron back and he says, I'm sorry. You're right. I'm wrong. Hashem is right. Please pray to Hashem. Please tell Hashem how sorry I am and make this terrifying storm stop, and I will let the Jewish people leave Egypt. Moshe's like, you're seriously, you're going to let us leave? You're not going to change your mind? Pharaoh's like, me? Change my mind? Never. So Moshe says, okay, I'm going to go pray to Hashem, and the storm will stop, and you're going to let us go, right? And Pharaoh's like, yes, I'm going to let you go. So Moshe prays to Hashem, and the thunder stops, and the lightning stops, and the rain slows down to a little drizzle, and the hail stops falling from the sky and the fire stops falling from the sky. And Pharaoh says, yeah, actually I changed my mind. You can't leave Egypt. And that's the end of Parshat Vaera. So we're going to have to stay tuned for next week to find out if and how the Jewish people get to leave Egypt. Shabbat Shalom.